Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends. In this video, we will study about what is the unit of measurement. So let us start with our topic. When we are doing any measurement, then we express the result of the measurement in the form of two parts. One is the number and second is the unit of measurement. So here we are going to study that what is called the unit of measurement. The unit of measurement is the basic unit in which, or it is the basic quantity in a given system of measurement. Okay. So if we technically define the unit of measurement, it is the definite magnitude of a physical quantity defined and adopted by convention or by law that is used as a standard for measurement of the same physical quantity. Suppose that when we are doing the measurement of the length, okay, so we want to find the length of a paper. So we are expressing the length in the form of, like suppose 2 meters, okay, we are expressing the distance in the form of the length, like the distance between two objects is 2 meters. So this is the result of the measurement. Now here 2 is the number and meters is the unit. So whenever we are measuring the physical quantity, a physical parameter like distance or the length we are measuring, so we are expressing it in the form of meters. And this meter is the basic quantity in which we measure the length. So unit of measurement is the definite magnitude of a physical quantity, and this is the standard quantity, and this standard is given by some law, by some convention. We have defined this, and this will be used for the physical quantity, like meters will be used for the length. So always when we are expressing the length, we will give the unit as meters. Okay. So that is called the unit of measurement. So in simple language, if we define the unit of measurement, then we will say that unit is the basic quantity in a given system of measurement. Now, this unit of measurement can be used to express the other quantities also. Like if we want to express any other value of the physical quantity, then that quantity will be some multiple of the basic unit of the measurement. Like if we are measuring like distance, so distance we are measuring like in meters, we are measuring the length of the, or the distance between the two objects is 2 meters. So 2 is the multiple which we are providing, the numerical value which we are providing, and meter is the basic basic unit. So all the other physical quantities, they will be a kind of multiple of this basic unit. Okay, now suppose we are taking that the length of this the distance between this or the length of this wall is like 10 meters. So 10 is what? This multiple, and basic unit is what? The meters. So all the other physical quantities, as I have said here, they will be expressed as the multiple of the basic unit of the measurement. Now examples of the unit of measurements are like yards, meter, inch, okay, like kilograms, liters. All are the unit of measurement. Like yards, meter, inch, we use to measure the length. Kilograms, we use to measure the weight. Liters also, we use to measure the weight of a liquid. Okay. So these are all the unit of measurements. Now there are some units of measurements which are a combination of the different basic units, like for example force. We know that force is equal to mass into acceleration. Okay, so mass is, we measure mass in the form of kilograms. Okay, that is the mass. And acceleration is what? The velocity per time, that is meter per second square. Okay, so here the force is expressed, the unit of the force, that is Newton, it is expressed as the combination of the two basic units, that is kilograms and the meter per second square. So meter is for the length, kilogram is for the mass, and second is for the time. Okay, so these, there are some units which are expressed as the combination of the basic units. Now basic units are for mass, for length, and for the time. So all the other units, they are expressed in terms of these three units. In the form of mass, we have the kilograms. For length, we have the meter. And for time, we have the second as the standard unit of the measurement. So all the other units, they will be expressed in terms of these three basic units. Now these units of measurements, they are independent of the environmental conditions. So these units, they are independent of the environmental conditions. There will be no effect on it. So we can say that unit of measurement is independent of the physical and the environmental conditions. Now these units, they are of two types. One is the fundamental unit and other is the derived units. Now fundamental units, they are further of two types, primary fundamental units and auxiliary fundamental units. So this is the classification of the units. Let us study the fundamental units. Yeah. Now, fundamental units are the basic units, the units through which, like all other units, they can be expressed in terms of these fundamental units. So those units are like, for length we are having the meter, for mass we were having kilogram, and for time we were having second. So when the units they are expressed in terms of the primary units or basic units, they are called the primary fundamental units. So in mechanics we have three primary fundamental units: length, mass and time. We cannot express length and mass and time in terms of other units. Okay, next type of units are the auxiliary fundamental units. Other than the mass, length and time, there are some units in the thermodynamics which come under the category of auxiliary fundamental units, like for current we are having ampere as the unit of measurement. So these are the, other than the units in the mechanics, we have some units which are expressed in the thermodynamics, and these are called the auxiliary units. Okay, like thermal electrical units, like for current we have ampere, for temperature we have Kelvin, for amount of a substance we have mole, and for luminous intensity we have candela. So these are the seven fundamental units, and all the other units, they can be expressed in terms of these fundamental units. The next type of units are the derived units. So derived units are those units which can be expressed in terms of the fundamental units, and all the other units other than these seven units which we studied, they come under the category of derived units. So derived units, they can be expressed in terms of the fundamental units, and every derived unit, it originates from some physical law which is defining that unit. Okay, like we studied for the force. So for force we have the unit as the Newton. Now Newton is a derived unit because we know that force is equal to mass into acceleration, that is m into a. Okay, and mass is what? Meters. And acceleration is mass is what? Kilogram. And acceleration is meter per second square. So what we can say that Newton is equal to kilogram into meters per second square. So fundamental units are involved in this derived unit, and this derived unit has originated due to some physical law which is defining that unit. Okay, so these are the various types of unit of measurement available, like fundamental and the derived units. So in this video we studied that what is a unit of measurement, how we can define the unit of measurement, and what are the basic units of measurement, fundamental and the derived units. So I hope that this topic is clear to you. Thank you.